up in the morning and out to school. The teacher is teaching the golden rule.
Welcome back, everyone. Dr. Theresa Ramsey from the Center for Natural Healing is here, and today we are talking more about getting the kids back to school and how to get them focused through nutrition. Everyone always says make sure your kids have a good, healthy breakfast before school, but it's really critical, right?
It's critical. Breakfast is actually the most important meal of the day. We've talked about that before. And what's interesting is how many children have focus issues. So we're getting phone calls from the teachers, and just in the fact that the FDA says 1 in 6 children have focus issues. That's a huge number. If there's 30 kids in the class, that's 5 kids in a class.
Exactly.
That are going to be disrupting the class, perhaps not learning well themselves. And we're seeing more and more of this now because of nutrition, improper nutrition, which has started years ago with our soils being less nutrient dense, with the foods that our kids are eating more calorie dense and nutrient deficient. It doesn't feed the brain.
You know, it's funny because when I couldn't get my kids to eat the first day of school because they were so nervous, I thought, you know, I wonder, because when you really start adding up how much sugar they're getting, all those hidden sugars.
Right, which there are.
You wonder how that alters their personality, their focus, and everything. Mm-hmm, so what can we do? I mean, we know, obviously, fruits are better and so forth.
Well, when I treat children that have the diagnosis of ADD or ADHD, the first thing I'll do is food allergies, and guess what I see? Across the board, dairy and wheat.
Really?
Dairy and wheat. And within a 2-week period of time, like you said, you're not sure how food is affecting them. Within a 2-week period of time, I will get calls from parents and teachers and psychiatrists saying, what did you do? I mean, in 2 weeks, you can see a huge difference in children.
By taking those two
just
groups.
Taking them out.
So that's one thing to do. That would be a simple blood test, right?
Yes, or without even testing, if your children's having difficulty focusing, look at those two foods. And the third thing I would say is the amount of sugar they're taking in, just like you said.
That would be my thing,
the amount of sugar. Allow them to get their sugar from fruit. I mean, that would be the best suggestion I could give.
Okay, because a lot of the prepackaged stuff, if you read, sugar is huge.
Right, and if you look at life-giving nutrients, and you have a package, and it's got a 5-year shelf life on it, I don't know how life-giving that is.
Good way of putting it. What are some of the things you brought here?
Okay, these are nutrients that we find habitually deficient in children that have focus issues. And habitually we will see fish oil deficiencies. In fact, I don't know, here's a picture. And this is basically a picture of the brain. I don't know if they can zoom in on this. And all this is showing is, after a few months, we lift it up of taking fish oil. You see the right amygdala there? That's our behavioral center of the brain, enlarged in just a few months of taking fish oil.
Wow. And what's this side over here?
So that's, this is the right side is behavior. The left side is more of our thinking. So this is behavioral.
And it actually grows?
Grows, which enhances our behavior and performance. So that's the effect of fish oil. This is one picture. There's many scans out there that show you what changes with taking fish oil. And for children, the type of fish oil that's essential is the DHA portion. We talk about cod liver oil, which is amazing. But DHA is the portion that nurtures the brain more than the EPA.
How can we get our kids to take this? Because does this taste any... is this good?
I'll let you taste it if you feel like it, but you know how you do it? Remember that beautiful shake I brought last week
and
my son drank
it down?
Put it right in there. They don't even know it's in there.
So how much of that would they need?
A teaspoon.
A day?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Great breakfast too. Put it in that pink shake, put some fruit in there, and it'll hide the taste. Don't even tell them. If they know it's in there, they're not going to drink it, so just don't even tell them.
Now, what about all those vitamins that I know a lot of us moms give our kids, the little gummies?
Well, I brought a vitamin.
Okay, here's
a
better one that you recommend.
I am going to have you taste this because it doesn't taste like, I grew up on Flintstone vitamins.
Okay.
It's not awful.
It's a cute little teddy bear.
They make them look nice.
Okay, I'll try it because if...
Like you found out with my son last week, kids get used to it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's not awful. It has a little bit. Mm-hmm. It's like a sweet and sour taste. Okay,
it's good.
Yeah. So good nutrition. Why? Because we're not getting it from our foods. Digestive enzymes. Why? Because we're not digesting our foods. We talked about that. Those mint enzymes that you take, children like those as well. The other thing that's really critical are minerals. And these are liquid minerals. And I think I will have you taste them just to show that
she's going to do this.
Really,
the vitamin, I think I can get my kids. I mean, they may not love it, but...
Exactly.
It's definitely easy to get down.
And they don't love it, but after a while, they don't mind it.
So disguise the oil.
That's right.
And this is, now, what is it? These
minerals.
Are the minerals.
These are just minerals, liquid minerals. That's all it is colloidal minerals. It's got some vitamins in there, too, but it's mostly minerals. It's kind of got that sweet flavor,
too. It tastes kind of good, actually.
I like it. Again, with kids, they're going to fight us with new stuff, but if we tell them that it has to be done or they get their Game Boy taken away, they're going to dig it.
Yeah.
You know?
Game Boy's been taken away already. You know, what I was thinking is you can make this what I found is when I take this stuff, like, Mom, what is that? I'm like, oh, you can't have any. This is my sugar water thing. Mm-hmm. And they're like, oh, can I try it?
Sugar water thing.
You lie.
Right.
Small little one.
Right.
But this is actually good. I like this.
Right. And what does this do?
Minerals
are essential for the conduction of our nervous system so that, you know, our brain and our behavior is smoother. It kind of smooths out that pathway. That's the easiest way I could say it.
And you were saying that so many kids today are of the ADHD diagnosis. We're getting more and more of that.
More and more, unfortunately. And you know what it is? I think we're trying to force children into a system that's not changing. The world is changing, and we're forcing our children to continue to act the same. There's so many wonderful people that had ADD that influenced our lives. This is a picture. I'm going to tell you some of them. Eisenhower, Beethoven, Stevie Wonder, President Lincoln, Magic Johnson, all these wonderful people. What would happen if we would medicate them and suppress them? They have affected our lives in so many beautiful ways.
Yeah.
And so it's working with children. It's having more patience. It's spending more time with them. It's understanding their individuality.
Hmm.
You know, there's so much more. Yes, nutrition is a big, you know, predisposing factor, but it's how we're parenting is a really big thing. It has to change.
Well, I like what you brought, too. So keep in mind some of the recommendations that you brought
yes.
as far as the vitamin E and helping your kids and obviously getting them to eat properly is huge.
Huge. So. Yes. And you're doing a great job. Congratulations.
I am sticking to
it.
I love it, but that's my job.
Yes.
So if you would like more information on Dr. Ramsey and the Center for Natural Healing, you can go to our website or dial our hotline. And I'll tell you, those two things I had were both, that drink thing was good.
Yeah.
Really good. So.
And now hide the fish oil in the drink and
you're set.
We got it all.
All right. Gail, you and Dr. Allie talking about, you know, stress with work and all that stuff. You don't have any here, do you?
No.